was the proponent of utilitarianism. Now, in the utilitarianism, two words are coming out. That main purpose of the things in your syllabus, Bentham is not there, so I am not discussing. But I am going to touch Bentham because in some cases the Bentham, some kind of the when you are going with the some comparative analysis, that time the Bentham matters. As for example, if you have listened my class very mindfully, somewhere here and other philosophically, I have said that this is Bentham's world. So Bentham means a lot. Bentham means a lot. Because the Bentham, with the Bentham, the idea of the utilitarianism has came out. Last day I have discussed the Hard Times, Charles Dickens, those things I have discussed. So the utilitarianism concept has came out. Very simply try to understand this thing. Mainly two words are there around that this concept has came out. Mainly two words are there. What are the two words? One, easily you are getting utility. Utility. Second thing, happiness. Now, what is happiness? What is happiness? As Bentham is saying, balance of pleasure, how nice you see, balance of pleasure over pain caused by one act. That is happiness. If you are doing something at that time, simultaneously pain and happiness, both the pleasure, both the things is going to come out. If the pain amount is higher than the pleasure amount, then it is painful. You are not going to get the happiness. Always try to possess very simplistic idea about the things. Again and again I am saying that UPSC never goes for some kind of thick spectacles kind of the observation. It doesn't matter. It is myopia, one kind of myopia. Right now you have one good spectacles, but it is myopia. So don't get into that. Always try to make the things very easy, as your Einstein has said. That if you do not have the understanding about that particular things, that means a fool can also read. But understanding matters to the expert. So try to be the expert and try to go with Dev Mukherjee. Happiness means balance of pleasure over pain caused by one action or act. So that is happiness. Your Bentham is giving the idea. So anyhow, if you are getting some kind of the better kind of the pleasure, then it's okay. The life is okay. Now the utility. What is utility? That means from something, whatever the thing, some act or some items, whatever may it be, from something, when you are, getting or you are finding it useful. So that is the utility. So Bentham is giving the idea of the world where utility and happiness, that's all. He is not concentrating on the means. Your Gandhi is coming in your mind. He is saying, anyhow, if you are finding something useful, then it's okay. You carry on. And you just check with the things, keep comparing with the things, that after this access of this useful particular things, whether you are getting happiness or not. That means, in some reverse way, you are getting the things. That means when you are doing some action, Bentham has not given you any idea, or that person couldn't think that how to maximize the pleasure to the most. Whatever you are doing or the act you are going, he was very much ensured with the idea that you are going to get the pain there. So at this end, at the fullest exercise of the utilitarianism or liberalism, whatever may it be, you the people, I hope I am not going to repeat, I have given you the idea about the Hard Times, Charles Dickens, that the thing I have said.
So now the thing is there. So that is the utilitarianism idea of Bentham. Balance of pleasure over pain caused by one action or act. And from something when you are finding it useful, then it is the utility. But from here, the theory of diminishing utility is coming. Go point by point. You just take it like that. I never advertise or speak, but one thing I can say, that there was a time when for the first time I have went with my students in the UPSC mains in the 2017, when finally we get the selection. That time we have got the All India second highest number in political science and IR. I am not trying to, by presenting this particular fact in front of you, I am not trying to present myself as the messiah in front of you, or I am not expecting that you the people are going to give me some kind of the acknowledgement to my credentials. I am trying to empower you, empower your mind. So that's all. So the theory of the diminishing utility is there. What this diminishing utility is saying? See, the thing is there. As for example, I always give the live example. On your childhood days, what you the people used to crave for one pencil or pen during the childhood days. But today try to think about yourself, do you crave for this? You used to cry, or you used to always negate your parents, make me purchase one pencil. Everybody would have with same kind of the experiences in your life, right? Yeah? But slowly, as you have got the first, second, third, fourth, and in this way you are getting the pencil or the pen, it has started to, your utility has started to be get diminished. So it has been get said that the first bite of the bread always brings happiness. But more you will go with that particular food, and slowly the utility actually has been get diminished in front of you, and the happiness also has to be started to be get lowered, and one day it is going to be get evaporated. These days you the people do not think about that whether you need that exact amount of rice or that, or you love rice or not. These days people, because, but you please try to understand, rice is the main staple food, but you the people do not care. Always try to be the philosopher inside, right? Now you the people never care. You look after what the other kind of the menus are there in your plate. So that is the Bentham. Bentham has given the idea of this particular world. Now from there, so the Bentham, so we always say that when we see that the materialism is rocking at the top, that means you are forgetting all about your morality, ethics and integrity. Though you are writing in the paper of the UPSC GS paper 4, but in your life or you speak a lot in front of everyone about what your ethics is, what your morality is, what it should be, what it should not be. But when at the level of your personal level or your neighborhood life, when we the people always exercise this thing, nobody give one damn to this particular thing. But it is not the sacrosanct whatever they are doing, right? Na? So I am not getting into that particular kind of the debate. I am coming directly. So that is the Bentham's idea. So this is Bentham's world. But in Bentham's world, your Gandhi has taken birth. In your Bentham's world, one gentleman Socrates has taken birth in the BC. In this Bentham's world, your just now your meal has taken birth. And your this Bentham's world, your lock is going to take birth. In this Bentham's world, your hopes is going to take birth. So that is not the arbitrary, sorry, I'm saying the wrong word. This is not the absolute. So Bentham maybe get exercised, but the people who exercise this thing, you be sure in front of your face or overtly, these people never is going to commit this kind of the act. These are the cooked people. These are the cooked people. Right now, I am a very plain speaking person. These are the cooked people. These are the some kind of the people. They have the multiple colors. And for that reason, now they need some kind of the filter when they appear in front of the people. But inside, the happiness nowhere is there. Because after material, if you are chasing the material, you never you are going to get the happiness. You be sure your mind is now going to teach you this thing. So we are directly we have entered into the scene. Note down. Don't forget. Right now, note down. So the meal is going to enter into this particular thing. So firstly, meal is directly taking one after one issue. Meal was one of the best person who has been got judged or has been got revered as the staunch individualistic thinking that he used to possess. So he was a staunch believer. Mill was the staunch believer of the individualism. Mill was the champion of liberty. But at this end, that liberty has given birth to utilitarianism. Justly we have seen, liberty has given birth to utilitarianism. So still, why were chasing after the mill? But me here entered and me has given the idea of reverse the idea of the traditional concept of utilitarianism. With one blend of human touch. Here the meal is the champion. So what your gentleman meal is saying about the pleasure? Meal has concentrated point by point. Meal, see also question remains from meal or lock. Right now, easily anybody can write. If you with some blank eye you read mill or go to some kind of the tuitions of that kind of the things, whatever may it be, mill most of the people mug up and they cannot pictureize the things in the examination paper or when somebody is speaking, simply speaking about mill, because that is because of the lack of understanding. But one of the easiest theory is there in the philosophical domain, that is the Mill's theory. Go point by point the way I am moving. See, Mill has went after the qualitative pleasure. Note down, qualitative pleasure. Pleasure, already we have went with. Qualitative pleasure. Mill to me, quantitative pleasure was not important. So I have cross marked that. Quantitative, you are amassing a lot of wealth by duping people. You are dealing in the prostitution. You take bribe. You are getting quantity, but quality matters. So Mill has said, sensual pleasure. So these things, quantitative pleasures, are going to give you sensual pleasure. Sensual pleasure is always inferior to intellectual pleasure. But he was also aware about the things that if you are not enough knowledgeable, not by bookish knowledge, if you are not enough knowledgeable, you cannot enjoy this qualitative pleasure. You will be in to the sensual pleasure. With the bankruptcy of morality, ethics and integrity. You are a human, but you will not be human. So a government gets it nicely, merely saying, a human, I am writing, a human satisfied, a human satisfied is better than one pig satisfied. How nice, you see, a human satisfied is better than one pig, sorry, a human dissatisfied, a human dissatisfied is better than one pig satisfied. Socrates dissatisfied is better than human satisfied. How nice, you see, a human dissatisfied is better than one pig satisfied. Socrates dissatisfied is better than human satisfied. So you see, that gentleman has taken the name of the Socrates. Socrates has chosen the death, swallowed the hemlock by self. State has shown the mercy. That what you are saying, you just ask for one sorry. Socrates said no. That philosophy from where it starts, that Socrates said no. For that reason, one person who is going during the 19th century is taking the name of one man belonging to the BC. So it is about the qualitative pleasure. Qualitative pleasure. Another thing nicely it has been get said, one proverb, Egyptian proverb is there. The person who tasted the water of the Nile, the name of the river, never will take any other water. The person who has tasted the water of the Nile never will take any other water. You know that the very clean water, the Nile water, the river Nile, right now? So when you are getting into the intellectuality, you are concerned about your qualitative pleasures. You never will exchange it for the quantitative pleasure. But if you are one pseudo-intellectual, then I cannot say anything. Mindfully, I am saying I cannot say anything. So the world is full of pseudos. The person who is around your arms, the person who is looking at you and looking at your eyes is saying, I believe in the God. He is giving what damn to the God. He or she is roped up everything. You are seeing the car, the people are going, knock the door of everyone. How many cars has been got purchased with the blood money, hard-toiled money? You are saying, sir, you are accusing one greater section of the population. I am not accusing, I am just presenting the fact in front of you. If India has been got prospered so much, then why it has not been get reflected in the GDP? If your income is not getting rationalized with your GDP, that means you have unaccounted money in your system. unaccounted money means what? Hidden money that never comes under the tax. If people are doing this thing, then do you think that these are the qualitative pleasure? It is not. If you are robbing someone, if you are robbing someone in front of people, you are presenting yourself as one saint or one god or goddess. You can live your life, but in your life, never the pleasure is going to stay. In this way, thousands of people are going here and there. Meal challenge that. So from here the meal, the man who has started with the liberty is going to make you land to the liberalism. Ben Thoma's idea. Charles Dickens, hard times. Father is reaching for the sensual pleasure to the pursued land. The girl is opening the door, and the girl is not the girl. Girl was his daughter. So that the idealism, the Benthamism is leading. But he has started with the same thing, but he has taken one cue from there. First we hit the things on the things. That is the qualitative pleasure. By this time, I hope it is clear in front of you. That is the diminishing effect of utilitarianism, that the concept already I have given you. So these are the ideas of the J.S. Mill. We are getting into more deep. So that is one idea. Now we will go to the self-regarding action and other regarding action.